Good morning students, today we are going to study a new lesson, sound. Okay, it is very interesting topic. In this we are going to study first the introduction, then we will go slowly for the production of sound and propagation of sound. Okay, so in previous classes you have studied about sound. What is sound? Okay, in our nature you can hear many voices, many sound you can hear. Now also you can hear what I am talking about. Okay, so what is this? This is a form of energy. Different forms of energy you have studied. You have studied light energy, sound energy, mechanical energy, many energies you have studied. Okay, in that one form of energy is the sound energy, which you are going to study in this lesson. All the things about the sound you are going to study in this lesson. So first we'll see about the definition of sound. So now if you will, at morning if you will go out of your house, what you can see? You can hear different sounds of birds. Okay, many sounds you can hear. So what happens? What is that? That is, it is something that reaches our ear. Okay, in light what it was? It was a form of energy which enables us to see the objects. Similarly here, what is sound? Sound is a form of energy which enables us to hear. Okay, which enables us our ears to hear the sound. That is called as sound. Okay, so in this sound, how the sound is produced? Have you ever thought? There are many musical instruments, many things are there which can produce sound. Okay, in your house also there are utensils, vessels are there, it also produces sound. Our vocal cords also produces sound. Okay, if anything fall down, then also you can hear the sound of the object falling down. Okay, so all that these things produce sound. So how it is produced, what happens actually, that all you are going to study in this lesson. You can see here, sound, it is a form of energy which enables us to hear. Now first we will see, in today's video you are going to see just the introduction of sound. Okay, so what it is, how it is produced? It is produced by a striking of tuning fork. What is tuning fork? Now it is a U-shaped. Okay, if you will see this tuning fork, it is U-shaped with a handle. Okay, and it is made up of metal. Totally it is a one piece made up of metal, like this. The shape is shown here. It is totally made up of metal. It has a handle and it has two arms. Okay, and these arms are called as prongs. These two arms are called as prongs of tuning fork, and this part is called the stem of tuning fork. Okay, this object is used to produce this vibrations. Okay, for vibrating, if you want to produce vibration, this tuning fork is used. And because of this vibration, what happened? When you strike, what you have to do? You have to take the tuning fork in your hand. You have to take a rubber pad, and in that you have to strike it. When you will strike, what happens? There is a vibration in the prongs. Okay, and when the prongs will vibrate, that time what happens? It will produces vibration. The tuning fork is used for producing the vibrations. And also what happens? It produces a small sound. When you take it closely to your ears, you can hear the vibrating sound. Okay, so tuning fork is used by plucking a string, a stretched string. If you know now, violins, guitars, all have a stretched string. Okay, but in guitar what happens? When you will pluck the string of the guitar, that time you can see that the string vibrates, and when the string vibrates, it produces the sound. Okay, then flicking thin rulers, this you all have done. Okay, you all have thin rulers. If you will keep the ruler on the table, half on the table, half outside the table. Okay, and if you will flick the scale, what happens? It will start vibrating, and this vibrations produces the sound. You can hear the sound of such vibrations. Okay, one more most important thing that you all are missing is your school bell. Okay, when the you can also hear the school bell ringing. When the school bell rings, what happens? You are able to hear the sound. Okay, because the school bell is actually outside, it is ringing outside somewhere, but each classes, each student can hear the sound. So have you ever think how it reaches to everyone's ear? Okay, there is something that makes the sound to reach to our ear that you are going to study in next video, that is propagation of sound. So in this all cases you can say these are used to produce the sound. The sound is produced by tuning fork, stretched rubber string, then flicking the thin rulers. All these, so common thing was there. What was the common thing among all these things? In all these things we found that all these things were vibrating. Have you seen this? Tuning fork was vibrating, rubber string was vibrating, flicking the thin ruler, it was also vibrating. A simple example I can tell you, take a rubber band in your two fingers and just flick it. You can see the rubber band vibrates and it also produces the sound. So from this what conclusion you can get? You can conclude that vibrating bodies produces sound. What produces sound? Very important this is. Vibrating bodies produces the sound. One more example just you can do. I will give you a 1 minute in your home. Now you can do. Try it. Now just keep your fingers here. Okay, and try to talk or try to make some voices. Just keep your fingers over here on the throat. And just try to speak. Okay, you can hear here also at the vocal cord, you can hear the vibrations. Okay, means here also the vibrations are produced. While talking, if you touch your throat, you can feel the vibrations. And here also you can understand that vibrating bodies produces sound. Understood this concept? Now I will explain you about the tuning fork. What is tuning fork? Actually it is a U-shaped single metal piece with an handle. It has arms are called as prongs, stem is this handle is called as stem. Okay, and for what purpose it is used? This is very important, you should know this. Question can also come about the tuning fork. Okay, you have to explain diagram, explain and for what purpose it is used. For what purpose this tuning fork is used? It is used to produce certain frequencies. If you see the tuning fork, it is made up of, it is made for producing different vibrating frequencies. Different frequencies it is produced. Okay, so if you want to produce some certain frequencies, then what happens? That frequency tuning fork is used. It is hit on the rubber pad and then what happens? The string arms vibrates, okay, which produces the desired number of frequencies. Okay, amount of frequency. So for what purpose tuning fork is used? It is used to produce sound of certain frequency. Okay, so this was about the tuning fork. Now you will start. This is a very important thing. See, sound needs a medium to propagate. In light, what you have studied, light don't need any medium to propagate. Without medium also light can propagate. As you have know, the sun, moon, stars, all these are present in the vacuum, but still you can see the light of the sun. Why? Because it don't need any medium to propagate. Sun, moon, stars, all are emitting their light and that light reaches to our eyes also, because from vacuum also light can pass, it can pass in our earth also. Okay, in all medium it can pass, but there is an exceptional case for this sound, that sound cannot pass through vacuum. Okay, this is very 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 important, that sound cannot pass through vacuum, but sound can pass through solid, liquid and gas, that is air. In air also sound can propagate. Okay, sound can propagate. Now here I am talking, means in this room there is air. Air medium is there here. Okay, I am talking means sound is propagating through the air medium and it is reaching towards you. Okay, so what is this means? Here sound needs a medium to propagate. Now liquid also, you know, liquid also sound can travel, and in gas means in air medium also sound can travel, but the optional cases here I have written, it is very very important that sound cannot pass through the vacuum. Okay, in vacuum you cannot hear any sound. That's why when any astronaut or if anyone is standing on the moon and if they are talking, another person cannot hear, because there is no atmosphere and there is no medium, it's all vacuum over there, and because of that sound don't get any medium to propagate and another person cannot hear the sound. Okay, So here sound can travel through solid, liquid, gases, that is air, but not through vacuum. It is very important. The matter. Now what is the medium? What is the meaning of medium? Now I have told you that it needs medium. Light, no need of any medium for the light, but sound needs a medium. What is actually a medium? Okay, it is a matter through which sound is transmitted. Okay, is called the medium. Means something we need through that sound should be transmitted. Okay, a medium or a matter or a substance, anything that can pass or that can transmit the sound, that is called as medium. So here sound needs a medium to travel. Okay, so into next video we will study about the propagation of sound. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you.